If you're like me, then you probably have a whole collection of empty notebooks because you can't help but buy them because of their beautiful covers, quality papers, and then before you know it, you've become a notebook hoarder.
But don't worry, because today I'm going to be showing you some creative, fun ways to fill up those empty notebooks. Let's just get started. Hey guys and girls and everyone in between, it's Ashna, and guess what? You were meant to click on this video, so let's make sure that wasn't for nothing. The first way to fill up an empty notebook is the classic, journaling. Journaling has been around for decades, for good reason. It helps you relieve stress, build new habits, and learn new things about yourself. If I'm being honest though, journaling requires a lot of effort, so scheduling a specific time, whether that's before bed or in the morning, will help you integrate it into your life. Also, don't feel afraid to write whatever's on your mind. Even if that's dinner, write it down. If you need even an extra little push, I have some prompts down below in the description that you can check out to start journaling today. Overall though, I just really love journaling as a whole because it has really helped me reflect on decisions I've made and how to improve my reactions in the future. Also, I don't think there is anything cooler than having a day-by-day account of your mindset and your headspace during a certain time, especially because of what we're going through right now. Your future self will thank you if you keep a journal, because you will have such a nice recount of your life. Okay, everyone, my next idea is the over-talked-about bullet journaling. If you've been here from the start, you know that I used to be a completely bullet journaling channel, and until recently, I stopped. This does not mean that it isn't for you, though. It is such an amazing hobby. You can write down your tasks, plan your week, and I honestly think it is perfect for anyone who can't find a planner out there for them and needs a customizable planner that they make themselves. Bullet journals are normally these dot grid sort of notebooks, but I think a lined paper notebook would still work just as well. If you think that this idea is for you, don't forget to check out my older videos if you scroll down in the videos tab on my channel for some extra inspiration. I will also have my favorite YouTuber for this kind of stuff linked in the description. My next idea is something that you should do when COVID is out of the blue, and that is a pass it on journal with a friend. Basically, this concept is you write something and then you pass it to your friend, they respond to it and write something new, and they pass it back to you, and so on and so forth. This works especially well if you have a friend who you see relatively often, but not every day, and you want to do something creative and fun that isn't on your screen. You can pass along stuff like pictures, recipes, journals, comics, notes, experiences, whatever you like with that friend, and you can pass it as often as you would like or as unfrequent as you like as well. This idea is super customizable to you and your friend, and I think it's just a super fun idea. My final idea to fill up your notebooks is a collage notebook, and I will show you a step-by-step process of a collage that I made of my celeb crush, Finn Wolfhard.
Okay, everyone. Hello. Welcome back to the Screen Recording with Ashna. This is the screen recording show where the audio sucks and we do all kinds of cool stuff. Oh, yeah. Anyways, today we are going to be today we're going to be saving some pictures of Finn Wolfhard, my celebrity crush extraordinaire. Okay, everyone, just logging into Canva. Do you like my name? It says here, Crummy. That's the name I gave myself on Canva. So on Canva, there's a super cool feature where you can use frames right here. And I love using these because it adds such a cool look. Like, you can literally, you can literally put your images right into the frame. Double tap or double click if you use a computer, and you can move them how you like. Like, what do you think? Isn't that like such a hack? And then I kind of want to filter them so they're all the same, like, grayscale. Is because there's this like really nice tape that I've seen, and it's like grid patterned, like it's washi tape, and it's black with white grid on it. I like love it, but I don't actually have real ones, so life hack, I'm gonna make my own. I'm gonna print out my own. Is that weird? I don't know, I feel like it's cool. At the same time, I feel like it's weird. I don't know.
And then it was time to download it and print. I then cut out all my images in their collective shapes and the homemade washi tape I had made, and I created this really fun collage in this dot grid journal I had. My ultimate tool for this was my double-sided glue tape, which I will link in the description if you are interested. And honestly, I just had such a blast making this. You can customize this again to whatever you like, and it was just a lot of fun, not gonna lie. Okay everyone, those are all my ideas of how to fill up your empty notebooks if you are a notebook hoarder like me. I hope that you got some value out of this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up because that will greatly help this channel. Today's shoutouts are on the screen right now. Thank you so much to them. I love you all so much. Stay positive, and I'll see you all in my next one. Bye everyone!